Welcome to part 2 of Kanchipuram travel vlog. Trailokyanatha Temple, also called Tiruparithikundram Jain Temple, is an 8th century Digambara Jain temple in Tiruparithikundram in northern Kanchipuram in Tamil Nadu. The area around this temple is also called Jain Kanchi. This stone temple is dedicated to the Jain Tirthankaras, but is notable for integrating Hindu deities with Jain deities within the premises of this temple. Constructed in Dravidian architecture, the temple was built during the reign of Narasimhavarman II of the Pallava dynasty. The temple was expanded by Jain community with financial support of medieval Cholas, later Pallavas and Vijayanagara kings. The temple is administered by Department of Archaeology of the Government of Tamil Nadu as a protected monument, while it is maintained by hereditary trustees. It is one of the few Jain temples that feature a predominantly Dravidian style of architecture and is well known for its beautiful wall paintings and inscriptions that depict the life of Hindu god Krishna as well as other important Jain deities. Pallavas, the rulers of the region, embraced Jainism during their early years. As per local legend, the temple was constructed by the Pallava disciple of the sages Vamana and Mallisena. There are other legends which attribute the construction of the temple by Simha Vishnu, the first Pallava king during the last decade of 6th century. The other legend is that the temple is believed to have been built during 8th century around 800 AD during the reign of Pallava kings. The temple was originally under the control of traditional trustees for 600 years till 1991. From then, the temple is maintained and administered by Department of Archaeology of the Government of Tamil Nadu as a protected monument. Kanchipuram was once seat of Jainism and a famous center of learning. As per tradition, the place where the temple is located is called Paruthi, meaning cotton. The tradition continues in modern times as Kanchipuram is a famous center of hand-woven silk sarees. We are done with the famous Jain temple. Now we are heading to our next destination. We decided to have breakfast before proceeding to the next destination. During our breakfast, we also tried Kanjipuram Kovil Idli. It is a popular variety of idli from the temple town Kanjipuram. Now we are going to Kamakshi Amman Temple. It is an ancient temple dedicated to Kamakshi, the ultimate form of goddess Lalita Maha Tribhura Sundari. The Meenakshi Temple in Madurai, the Agilandeshwari Temple in Thiruvannaikavil, this Kamakshi temple are the important centers of worship of goddess in the state of Tamil Nadu. The temple was believed to be constructed by Pallava kings whose capital was Kanjipuram. The image of the main deity Kamakshi is seated in a majestic Padmasana, a yogic posture signifying peace and prosperity, instead of the traditional standing pose. As per Hindu legend, Kamakshi Amman is considered in line with Meenakshi at Madurai and Vishalakshi at Varanasi. Kamakshi is the only Shakti shrine centered across all Shiva temple in Kanjipuram, which do not have separate shrine for Amman. Kamakshi is worshipped thus as Parabrahma Surubini. She was initially very furious and was depicted as Ugra Surubini and became Shanta Surubini at the request of Adi Shankara, who installed Sri Chakra in the place. The mythology of Dakshayaga and Sati's self-immolation is the main theme in the origin of Shaktipidas. Shaktipidas are divine temples of Adi Parashakti. The cause of the presence of Devi's presence is due to the falling of the body parts of the corpus of Sati Devi. The navel part of Sati Devi's body is believed to have fallen here. There are 51 Shaktipidas linking to the 51 alphabets in Sanskrit. There are also arguments that the old Kanji temple is the Shaktipita, where Shankaracharya has installed the Sri Chakra. Four worship services are offered each day. The annual festival falls in spring in the Tamil month of Masi, which runs from mid-February to mid-March. During this time, the chariot festival and float festival are held. Other festivals include Navaratri, Adi and Aipasi Puram, Shankara Jayanti and Vasanthotsavam in Tamil month of Vaikasi. All Fridays are considered sacred. Though the Fridays in the Tamil months of Adi and Thai are celebrated. This temple is spread across 5 acres and located 4 kilometers from Kanjipuram town. With this, we are done with Kamakshi Amman temple visit. Now we are going to the next temple. This is Kaushigeshwarar temple. This temple is situated right in front of the eastern entrance of Kamakshi Amman temple. dedicated to Lord Shiva. The temple is believed to be built by Uttamachola during 9th century AD. Ulaganatha Perumal Temple. This is another old temple close to Kamakshi Amman Temple, Kanchipuram. This relatively small temple takes its name from Vamana, the fifth avatara of Lord Vishnu. Like Varadaraja Perumal, this temple too is one of the 108 Divya Desams. It features a traditional Dravidian style of architecture and is mentioned in the popular Tamil literature works dating back to the 6th century. According to the historian Nagasami, based on the inscriptions and the location of the temple, it is one of the oldest temples in Kanchipuram. There is another account that the temple is developed by Rajendra Chola I. The temple has 15 inscriptions from various dynasties like Pallavas, Chola and Shambhuvarayas. The temple has an area of around 60,000 square feet and has a three-tiered Rajagopura with 7 Kalashas. Bhagavata Purana describes that Vishnu descended as the Vamana avatar to restore the authority of Indra over the heavens, as it had been taken by Mahabali, a benevolent Asura king. The temple hosts nearly a dozen annual festivals and is popular for its annual Brahmotsavam and Thervida. This temple is comparatively smaller than the other temples in Kanchipuram. However, the architecture is very beautiful, like other temples. Chitragupta Temple. It is a temple located in Nellukkara Street, Kanchipuram. It is one of the rare temples of Hindu deity Chitragupta, considered to be the assistant of Yama, the Hindu god of death. Chitragupta is believed to have emerged from a painting and set as the accountant of good and bad deeds of human beings by Brahma. The present masonry structure was built during the Chola dynasty in the 9th century, while the later expansions are attributed to various others. The temple is maintained and administered by the Hindu Religious and Charitable Endowments Department of Government of Tamil Nadu. Satyanadeshwarar Temple, located 4 kilometers from Kanchipuram in Tirukkalamedu town. This 7th century temple is the smallest of the major temples of Kanchipuram, covering just 22,500 square feet. But it is of immense importance both in historical and religious terms. It is dedicated to Satyanadeshwarar, a form of Lord Shiva, and follows the Shaiva tradition. The main gopuram is made up of three tiers and features a sandam sanctorium that contains a lingam made of granite. Satyanadeshwarar Temple is also one of the 275 important Shiva temples mentioned in the Tamil Shaivate canonical work. This temple has two daily rituals at various times from 5:30 a.m. to 8 p.m. and three yearly festivals, namely the Margadi Thiruvadirai, Aipasi Annabhishekam and Mahashivaratri. Temple is maintained and administered by the Hindu Religious and Endowment Board of the Government of Tamil Nadu. According to legend, Indra, the king of celestial deities, and Bhudan, Venus, worship Shiva at this place located in a forest called Karaivanam. Since it was located in Karaivanam, the presiding deity came to be known as Karaivananathar, Satyanadeshwarar. During Wednesdays, devotees take a holy dip in the temple tank located outside the temple and worship Shiva with green pulse, which is considered a sacred aspect of Buddha, Mercury. Ashtabhuja Perumal Temple. It is a famous Vaishnavite place of worship in Kanchipuram. The temple's current form is a mix of architectural styles influenced by the Pallavas, Cholas, and Vijayanagara dynasties. Its most prominent feature is the temple pond located within its walls, which is associated with the mythological tale of Gajendra Moksha. The temple is originally believed to have been built during the rule of Pallavas. The temple has inscriptions from the period of Kulathunga Chola I indicating gifts of land to the temple. There are contributions mentioned in the same inscription indicating contributions from the local people for perpetual lighting of the temple. There are inscriptions in the southern walls of the temple from Kulathunga I indicating sale of lands by Rajasundari Chaturvedi Mangalam to meet the kitchen expenses of the temple. There are a lot of legends associated with this temple. One among is associated this temple to Gajendra Moksham, given by Vishnu to the elephant king Gajendra. As per the legend, the elephant Gajendra used to worship Vishnu with the lotus fetched from the temple tank every day. Once, while picking up lotus, a crocodile caught the leg of Gajendra, who started calling the name of Vishnu for help. Vishnu sent his discus to punish the crocodile and relieve the elephant. The temple rituals are performed 6 times a day. Also, weekly, monthly, and fortnightly rituals performed in this temple. The 10th day, Vaikuntha Ekadashi festival, celebrated during the Tamil month of Margari, is the most prominent festival celebrated here. Ramadhami and Navaratri are other prominent festivals celebrated in this temple. Gajendra Moksha festival is celebrated during the Tamil month of Adi in the star of Hastam. With this, we are done with Ashtabhuja Perumal temple visit. This is the end of this episode. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Stay tuned for the upcoming episodes.